Thank you very much indeed for the gesture of the Sutherland Shire book at the end of the wind ensemble rehearsal on Thursday evening. I had a very big thank you card from my young colleagues at the conservatorium, and those sort of little happenings are ever so lovely and give you a warm glow. Well, we hope this afternoon's program brings a warm glow to each one of you too, because it's very diversified, and to set things going, because we need to keep moving, we have a big program. Your own Sutherland Shire band is going to commence proceedings with a rather marvellous fanfare romance and finale by Philip Spark, who wrote some marvellous music and is writing currently marvellous music for brass band. Here is a band that serves the local scene with tremendous enthusiasm and vigour. They play in the normal little functions that happen in and around the city. And let's listen to them first. Their conductor is Bandmaster Frank McGuinness, father of Brian and George and Cheryl. He's the one that we give a warm welcome to, and your own band, Sutherland Shire.
Thank you. Thank you.
have heard at the very beginning, we had three young trumpet players taking part in the fanfare. And whilst we're just setting up stage for our next contribution, we mentioned those three students. One of them was Karen Newton, who stood in the middle at the back. And Karen is from Newcastle, from the conservatorium, and she is in the process of completing her music education course and the SCM, and a very talented young player. On this side, we had Leanne Sullivan, who is in the third year of a Bachelor of Music program. And on the other side of the stage, we had a young gentleman, well known to Sutherland Shire, who you've just heard playing soprano with your own local band, and that was Greg Stenning. And of course, he is a graduate from the conservatorium. So now we're going to move into hearing another trumpet player, but this little fellow who is representing a new age. Well, he's very young, he hasn't yet had a lot of solo experience, and I suppose facing a big audience like this might be his very first time. It's got to begin somewhere. And Gary Clark is going to play with the very admirable assistance of Molly Neal, also well known to folk in this part of the world and to brass band people everywhere, and as an accompanist. And Molly is going to support Gary Clark as he plays a theme, two variations, and a little final statement from The Arvin's Tutor. I hope he doesn't get stage fright, I don't think he will, and I'm sure you'll enjoy this contribution by Gary Clark.
and a very warm welcome here to Australia. This is the St Kilda Band. My name is Donald Reed, and it gives me great pleasure to be here this afternoon to introduce the band and the music they will play to you. The number you've just heard is Doyen. It was written by Gough Richards, arranged by that gentleman. And looking up my Oxford dictionary, I see the meaning of the word Doyen to be a senior member or a body, especially of ambassadors. And that's how we feel this afternoon, ambassadors here from Dunedin City in New Zealand, here in Australia. To give you a bit of a rundown on the band, Dunedin City is in the south of New Zealand. It really is the home of Carisbrook, which of course is the park where Australia suffered that unfortunate defeat yesterday. I'm sorry to run that in. It's also the gateway to Central Otago, which houses a lot of those beautiful lakes and mountains that the South Island of New Zealand is so famous for. Now let me introduce you to our musical director. And here he is, this gentleman standing over here, John Edgecombe. He's a very modest man, and so I won't say too much about him, except for the fact that he has an LRSM, he has an FTCL, he's a JP and an accountant. The first three we're sure very proud of. The last one, we've mentioned seldom. He first played in a band when he was 11 years old, and he plays the trombone, and for 36 years he's played that instrument. He's been in eight national bands. He has won eight national championships. He's twice been champion of champions of New Zealand. He's toured overseas with the national band in 1962 and 1985. He's the conductor of the Trusty Bank St Kilda Band, as you can see, and from 76 to 79 and 84 to date. He's responsible in no small way for the very high standard of this A-grade band from Dunedin. Now the next number the band would like to play, ladies and gentlemen, goes into pop. It's I Write the Songs. It was written by Johnson. The arrangement is by Jay Peabody. It was a hit when Barry Manilow recorded it. It's no less a hit when the St Kilda Band played. Ladies and gentlemen, I Write the Songs.
Thank you.
Kilda. So the band practices on the beach occasionally, and I'm sure you can see the healthy tan that they get there from lying on the beach in the beautiful sunshine of the evening. Perhaps a little exception yesterday. The next number we'd like to play was written by a gentleman who is totally blind, and in no way is his fame being diminished by that or his expertise. It is Stevie Wonder, and he has written this tune. It was written for another Negro musician, a tribute to his hero, who was Duke Ellington. And the name of the number is Sir Duke.
Thank you.
sure you all enjoyed that as much as I did. A magnificent little number and very well played. Now we have a look at the shows once again. And one of the shows written by Richard Rogers, this arrangement, a lovely smooth arrangement from the song, the show I should say, Pal Joey. And it provides an opportunity to feature cornets and horns with the band. And might I say at this stage that we can no longer refer to a band as band's men, because there are always ladies in the ranks, as you've seen before in the previous band that played, and indeed in this band here. And so I'd like to ask the ladies to stand. And we have Tania, Barbara, and the baritones Georgina and Karen. And it's lovely to see them there with the bloom of youth in their cheeks. I'm sure they're enjoying themselves this afternoon playing with the band. Now this is a very nice smooth arrangement, ladies and gentlemen. I could write a book. National band, which won the world championships in Holland, and tonight or today I should say, Gary plays the haunting solo from Summertime.
Oh.
Young bandsman, and shores to come to Australia. It reminds me of the story of Yehudi Menuhin when he was in America and he was to play at Carnegie Hall. And as he saw it was a great morning, he thought he would step out rather than taking a cab and get to the hall. And so he tucked his Stradivarius under his arm and away he went, stepping out towards Carnegie Hall. But as he was getting along the pavement, he realised before long that he was hopelessly lost and there was no way of getting to the hall in time. And he saw a heavy musician sitting in the gutter there tootling away on a flute. And so he approached that gentleman and said to him, "Excuse me, sir, could you tell me how I might get to Carnegie Hall?" And the hippie put down his flute and looked at the bar. And so that's what it takes to be famous, practice. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to call on our musical director, Mr. Edgecombe, to make a presentation of the band now to Mr.
Ladies and gentlemen, as everybody has already said, we are delighted to be here in Australia. When the idea of a band coming to Australia or making this trip was first mooted, I must confess that I was one of the cynics that didn't really believe that it would happen, because as you can imagine, there is an enormous amount of money involved, and the band, although we are a sponsored band, have actually raised all the wherewithal to get here on their own account. And so it's really all come out of their own pockets. As Alan Reesman said earlier, the man who has done more than anything for us in Australia to make arrangements is Ken Smith. And we have this particular affection for Ken Smith because he is really one of the most famous people to have passed through the ranks of the St Kilda Band. He conducted it for some time and very successfully at winning New Zealand championships. And he also won the New Zealand Open Corner Championship, did brilliant things with music, and he's left behind a legacy of this music, and we will never forget what he did for us when he was in Dunedin, and we certainly will never forget what he's done for us on this tour. And we have, as part of the preparation, arranged special banners, just in case anybody really forgets who we are, and we would like to take this opportunity of making a presentation to Ken of one of these banners so that he may hang it in some prominent place. I sincerely hope he would like to hang it in some prominent place to remind him of his association with our band. So Ken, on behalf of all the band over here, I'd like to do this.
Thank you.
show tune. And this song, or tune I should say, comes from Broadway's longest running musical show. It's from a chorus line. It's called New York, New York. And the arrangement we'd like to play this afternoon is actually by one of our Dunedin musicians and arrangers, Russell Shepherd. Ladies and gentlemen, from a chorus line, the song New York, New York.
Thank you.
great people, a whole band to show their talents. You know, in music, there is a great hero out there. He's a pop hero, of course, and in fact he was a legend of his own time, and a legend now after his death, and it was Elvis Presley. But before I introduce Elvis, which will be our final number for the band this afternoon, I'd like to introduce a gentleman over here, Peter McHenry, who's the chairman of the band. And I must say, ladies and gentlemen, if anybody's responsible for us being here, he's put in such an amount of work, he's organised raffles, he's organised selling of fish, and everybody's got together, got behind, earned their money, and got here to Australia. But Peter really has been a terror of strength. He's been right behind us all the way. Peter, please stand up and let the crowd see you.
Thank you.
combination of all the musicians you've heard this afternoon playing together. So stay on your seats and wait for the treat of the afternoon as the mass bands will play for you.
going, and we trust one day in not too distant future St Kilda may come back, and the horses may combine. Just a final word. As you retire, since it is a legacy project with the City Council on the band, as you retire, you may wish to make some contribution to the collectors who will be not confronting you, but they will be at the door. And could we just also say thank you to Mr. Mike Grant, Secretary of the Sutherland Band, for his tremendous